Do you need an eye cream? Is it a waste of money? The answer is yes. I'm going to take you through today. So many people ask me, why don't I have an eye cream specifically in my line? There's a great reason. There's a great formula that brightens the eye, helps exfoliate. It takes away blemishes and brown spots, also tightens it up and helps with the crow's feet. Taking you through all of it today, exactly how to do it. At the end of the video, exactly how to apply and layer it. Okay, so there's the under eye and the skin is sensitive, the skin is thin, and that's why people make eye creams. Now, the eye creams really are a waste of money for most people. It's a great way to market things and say, hey, it's meant for the delicate skin. The skin under the eye is 7 to 10 times thinner than the rest of the skin. The other thing is people doing peels around the eye are scared because if you use the wrong ones, you can get pigmentation problems. So people are like, well, I shouldn't use retinols under the eye. I shouldn't use AHAs under the eye. And that's simply not true. But you have to know your skincare. So what do I use instead of a dedicated eye cream? Well, something way better, because if you keep it simple and you use what you already have on your face or for your face in the right manner, you don't need to buy expensive eye creams and you can make your face creams go much longer and make it more cost effective for you. And if you travel like me, you don't need to take all these things. Also at the end, I'll tell you how to layer them, but also I'll give you a couple options if you want the next level beyond an eye cream. So what's my solution? Number one is my AHA 10% glycolic face cream. So it's 10%, and a lot of people, like with a retinol, you might say, oh my gosh, you're gonna use that under the eye? Well, guess what we do often before Botox around the eyes is a little add-on. We do a mini chemical peel. The under eye is so important. It's one of the first areas to age. But what's in that peel? You may be surprised to know. A little TCA, but glycolic and lactic acids. Now, where are they also found? They're found in my AHA cream, and they might well be in yours. I'm not saying you have to purchase mine. You might have an AHA cream that you love right now. You want to compare the ingredients to mine. Also know I'm talking 10% glycolic, and many, there are some creams that are 10%. It should tingle when it goes on. If not, you probably, it might say 10%, but is it a bioavailable? Is it an active 10% or not? You want to be on quality products. But the same things we use in clinic for an under eye peel are likely in your AHA cream, and they're in mine. The lactic and also the glycolic. Now, I did mention TCA, and if people are using TCA peels under the eye, it has to be a very, very light dose, but it's the glycolic. Why? Okay. The glycolic and the lactic. Number one, and there's three reasons, main reasons here. Number one, the glycolic does what? It exfoliates mildly, okay? Number two is the brown spots and blemishes. What is the number one thing that people get around the eyes that they come complain? They'll say the word dark circles, and it means many things. But one of the things AHA does so well is it brightens, it clears the skin, and a bright under eye makes a huge difference because light reflecting back makes it appear smooth. Irregular light going back or reflecting back to the person looking at you makes it look irregular, even if it's not, and it creates that an appearance of a bag under the eye, and often there isn't, it's pigment. And the third thing, which of course we love, it's tightening. I mentioned the bag under the eye, it's complex, it's fat pad herniation. At the end, I will give you some other treatments if you have a deep bag. However, for most people, mild to moderate bag under the eye, if you tighten the skin around the eye and the under eye, then of course, it reduces that appearance. So add those three things. Imagine if you exfoliate a little bit, if you brighten it and you tighten the skin, that's a great result for many people. Now, I'm gonna go into the second product that you're gonna layer with this. Understand, if you stop the video here for some reason, you can't hammer the under eye, it's very sensitive. So at the end of the video, when I talk about layering, it's important. Now, so you know what the AHA does. The second product in my line, and you might have one similar to this that you can substitute, is going to be my Ultra Moisture. Now, this is like a finishing cream. It was invented. I formulated it for people on the coast, the West Coast, that their skin was so dry, I couldn't get ahead of it. And then what happened about 10, 12 years ago, I was working on a doctor's set, and they're putting makeup on me before going on TV, and I put the Ultra Moisture on, and the girl's putting makeup on, and she's like, wow, what did you just put on your skin? It took all the fine lines and the makeup's going on perfectly. I know nothing about makeup. I'm like, well, she said, yeah, that's like a finishing cream. We'd love to have that before putting makeup. So they started purchasing it, but the key ingredient for the under eye that's in it is, there's many, and there's many oils. There's neem seed oil, there's willow bark, but the one I love for the under eye, and you'll hear, and it might be in your under eye cream that's used so common, grape seed oil. Now I have a whole video, I'll put in the links below, I'll put a link to the video on grape seed oil, and I'll put a little tag up here if you wanna watch that video, you should, it's a complete video on it. But what grape seed oil does for the under eye is phenomenal. And the reason it's in so many creams is it just helps with dark circles. That kind of redness that you get that looks like it's from lymphatic drainage problems or lymphatic obstruction, and just get that redness and the puffy look underneath the eye, grape seed oil helps with that. It's a very important antioxidant, of course, as we know, but there's something special about it. In fact, some people have patents on grape seed oil extracts in a certain way. Now, grape seed oil, you might drink a little wine once in a while, that can lead to puffy eyes, but that's where it comes from. It was almost a throwaway product for making wine from grapes. So it's readily available, but it's in one of many ingredients in my Ultra Moisture, which is a vegan cream, by the way. So that combination does well. Let's go into how you use it, because this is so important. I'm going to be able to use it very differently than you, one of many reasons. For one, male skin has a little thicker dermis, there's testosterone, so men are gonna get away with a little more aggressive schedule. A hypersensitive skin, you might only use this AHA once weekly, and then the Ultra Moisture the other 6 days. That's totally fine. Everyone's gonna have a different dose. You don't want inflammation. AHA and retinol can lead to increased inflammation if you use it too much. If you get a redness, if you get a windburn feel, you gotta back off. The under eye is very sensitive, you don't wanna hammer it. So what you wanna do, you wanna start Ultra Moisture. You can use every day, full face. You can even use it on the body, but the under eye is key, okay. Now, once a week, what you're gonna start with is you're going to put the AHA on and then layer on top with the Ultra Moisture or similar products that you might have, like I said. That's gonna buffer it so you don't get the full dose of the AHA. You'll even notice on your face where the skin is much thicker, you'll get a tingling from AHA creams, or you should. Okay, so the next thing you're gonna do is step it up. You're gonna go to twice a week. Then you're gonna go to three times a week. Now, if you're tolerating that, back off on the Ultra Moisture. You can just simply use Ultra Moisture in the morning, and in the evening, you're going to use your AHA standalone under the eye. You don't need to buffer it with the Ultra Moisture. You can play with those combinations. The key is, I don't want you to get inflammation, redness, or irritation. That leads to inflammaging. So when you have a product like this that works so, so well, you're going to be responsible for managing the side effects, the dose, and how you use it. Anything that's great can cause harm. So great devices can harm the skin because they're able to go to levels that not everyone can take. It's the same with skincare. You're able to take this. I don't know of anyone that uses it 7 days a week, but I know that for me, three times a week, I can take it, sometimes four. Beyond that, I'm gonna get inflammation. So it's not about how much you use, it's how much you use for your skin. Everyone will be different. Now, pro tip, I'll give you a couple. Number one, if you wanna protect the lashes or the lids, particularly for those using retinols, but also for AHA, retinols are more damaging to the eye itself, or retinoics. The AHAs aren't as damaging, but you want to keep them out of the eye. If you're unsure, you can put Vaseline around the eye or in any area you don't want this product to get to. That's what we do with chemical peels. It's what we do with retinols and so on. So that's one thing you can do to avoid getting spillover of AHA cream to where you don't want it. The next pro tip, the next step up for people, if you need a little boost, if you've got more of an under eye bag, if you've used this program for 2 to 3 months and you still want a tighter, better under eye, 100% natural, blood draw, platelet rich fibrin, and if you have a deep trough in there, we use Easy Gel, platelet rich fibrin gel, and I have videos on that, and you can see me get my treatment on this channel. I'll put a link for that video below as well, so you can watch that. So there's so many different stages for your eye, but it's exactly why I don't have an under eye cream, and it's exactly why I don't think you need one. KISS, keep it simple, stupid, is what we always teach to the students, meaning that less is often more. And in this case, you're getting way better result than any under eye cream that I'm aware of and have tried. And I've tried hundreds, maybe thousands. I've been doing this for over 25 years. That's your formula. What's your formula? I put a complete video up here of things you can do at home to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.